cover. She call me Mr. Bombastic, tell me fantastic. Touching on me back, she says I'm Mr. Rowe.
That's one sexy man.
There you go.
Thanks,
Scotty. That was nice.
That is awesome. I'm crying right now.
Unfucking real.
Only you, Scott. Only you, bud.
Let's go. It's Friday, everybody. Word on the street. Let's go. What's up, everybody? Happy Friday. It's time for Word on the Street. Welcome to the show. We're going to have a great show today. We're going to have a lot of fun, everybody. We got the street crew in the house. We got to welcome everybody into the show today. Coming to us from Boston, our good friend McNutt, Kyle McNutt in the house today. Oh, where's the music? We need to turn it up. Crank it up. There we go.
Hey, yo. Outside of the logistics here, baby. I'm doing it. I'm the bad guy. I'll be it. If that's what you want me to be, I'm just here to take names.
What's up, brother? Good to see you as always. Happy you're joining us today from your humble abode up there in Boston, Massachusetts. Also coming to us from Chicagoland today, the strongest grandpa in logistics. Give it up for the one and only Robert Bain, everybody. Good to see you as always, my friend.
Good to see you too, and Trey.
How's grandpa life, dude?
Oh man, grandpa life's great. I got to do some grandpa magic the other night. She was up. It was very, very late. The kids were, you know, very frustrated. Not really sure what's going on here.
Wait, am I the host now?
You're the host.
I'm the host.
I didn't want to hear it. I didn't want to hear it. Sorry, it happened. Just hit the wrong button. I got to stop touching buttons.
Oh, it's all good.
Talk about being Papa Bane
in the morning and take the child. I'm obviously calm and nice and warm. Just got out of bed and she calms down, stops crying. And these two kids look at me and I'm like, yep, it's grandpa magic. Here you go. Right. But Trey.
Yes, sir.
I have a surprise for you. It's going to be delivered in about 10, 15 minutes.
Oh, really?
Ooh, yep.
Real time? Let's go. Dude, I'm down. I'm up for that, man. Let's go. Tiger's going to go nuts when somebody shows up. Somebody's showing up? Is that what's going on? Is that what's happening?
I have a surprise for you, Trey.
All right. I mean, you're not even close. I was hoping maybe walk in the door. Yeah, I know. Like, I'm now curious. All right, we'll see what happens. All right, coming to us from New Jersey, everybody, the Bodacious Cowboy, Jeff Dickinson in the house.
Cause I saddled up my horse, but I ride.
Let's go, guys.
I make a lot of noise, all the girls, they are so pretty. Riding up and down Broadway on my own.
Love the hat.
And Trey's muted.
I'm muted.
This is an amateur show today. Amateur show.
Dude, what is going on, man?
Yeah, I'm excited for this surprise. What's happening, man? It's like
you threw him all off with this surprise, Bane.
Totally, man. Like the whole game is off. The whole game.
It was my intro video. It threw everybody off.
I'm still pulling off from it. I'm just saying.
Speaking of which, we got a special guest today. The one and only Katie Keach in the house, everybody.
The number you have dialed is not available at present.
Yeah, trendsetter, whoa, league of my own, it don't get better. No, read what I wrote, I'm a bestseller.
Dude, that song's a banger. I love that song. That is a layup line banger right there. That's a pregame special. Good to have you on the show, my friend. Good to have you. We're going to talk a lot about what you're up to. You're doing some cool stuff. Can't wait. And then, of course, the one and only, the Freight Sensei from the Boise, Idaho area. Everybody give it up for Scott Watanabe in the house.
I'm too sexy for my love. Too sexy for my love.
That's just for you, my friend. That's just for you. But I feel like we can't do a disservice to your song. We got to put your song in there. We got to.
Okay. I appreciate that. Let's go.
There we go. Let's go.
Concentrated power of will, 5% pleasure, 50% pain,
100% reason to remember the name. All right, said,
You mentioned from Boise, Idaho, but I'm here in the headquarters of our newest agency, Growin Project Cargo. They're an Armstrong agency. They had me come in and help onboard their first week of training for their newest rep. So it's been fun. It's been a great week. You'll see some pictures of me live in action, but it's good to be here in Bend, Oregon. Just a beautiful place. Awesome.
You sound like you lost your voice just a little bit. You've been having some fun?
Yeah, I have. I guess I did lose my voice a little bit talking all week.
I mean, the hoodie's looking a little snug, man. You've been working out a little bit. The neck getting
a brand new hoodie. I took your advice, Rob. You said anytime you travel, try to stay in your routine. So I've been up at 5:30 every morning, still hitting my gym. I brought my TRX bands and my jump rope, and then I ran for a run today. So yesterday I did a cold plunge in the cold 28-degree weather.
Oof, how long?
No thanks.
How long?
I was good. So the guy went, says 2 minutes. I think I went three, but we won't give him we'll give him too much of a hard time. Dude, I told him, send me the snapshots of the pictures. Because he's got an Android, so I know it timestamps it. So
he's got a potato phone, guy.
that's why the pictures you'll see are like pristine.
Sure. Yeah. The texts are green too. It's disgusting.
The texts are blue when it's me and him. So it's whatever. Yeah, I don't know what you're gross. Talking about.
You're nasty.
All right, we got to get this show started. Katie, it is so good to have you on the show with us today. First of all, we're glad you're here. We're going to send you a piece of swag. What do you want here? We got an option for you. Do you want the beautiful glass that we have, the coffee mug, or the water bottle? Which one do you want sent your way? I know. That's a tough choice.
That glass is sick. I ain't going to lie.
Nobody's got the glass yet.
I'm going to go with the glass. I was thinking that too. So you won my mind.
You'll be the first one with the word on the street glass.
Classic coaster that will go away in 5 seconds. You don't want to get one of those cardboard things? Come on, that's genius.
Look at some of these. Look at some of these right here. Look at this. This is the artwork of the one and only Natalia Navas, everybody. Look at this. Well, not this one. You made that one yourself, but put it on there.
That's awesome.
So cool. Absolutely love that. So it's awesome. So we'll get that glass your way, Katie. So good to see you. Now, Katie, you're on the show for a couple of reasons today. First of all, you're a cool human being. Second, you're doing cool stuff. Or as dope, or as Bane likes to say, you do dope shit. And then lastly, you are a basketball aficionado. And we got to talk about Steph Curry and Sabrina Ionescu, but not yet. So tell everybody a little bit about this podcast you're doing, the Keach legacy that you got going on. Tell everybody what's going on.
Yeah, so we started a nonprofit late last year called Keach Basketball Legacy. And then we started a podcast shortly thereafter called Life Beyond the Ball. And Keach Basketball Legacy is really focused on working with athletes that are training to become, you know, elite athletes, and working with them to understand, you know, what life after the game is going to look like, so that whether they play through high school, play through college, or even go into the pros, they understand, you know, financial literacy, accounting, social media presence, all the things, as well as having hopefully later this year a facility for them to train at so that we can help them. So we're focused on middle school through college and helping these kids build relationships with companies so that they can become the next employable generation.
Hell yeah.
This is so timely too, because with NIL and with what they're, I mean, things are going to change as well. They've got these co-ops now where boosters are basically pooling money together and giving it to players. Like the whole business of college basketball and college sports in general is changing. And who's out there teaching these kids? Who's out there really helping them and advocating for them? And also talking to them about, which I love, basketball's great. It can pay for college potentially, but you're probably not going pro. I mean, that's not going to happen for anybody. So what does that look like after the fact? I love the podcast that you and your husband have. I got a chance to be on the show, which was really cool. Had fun with that. My good friend J.D. Gravina is going to be on real soon. What's the easiest way for people to subscribe and to get those episodes?
Yeah, so we're on Apple, YouTube, everywhere there's a podcast, we're streaming. So check us out. You know what? You would have loved this last week. We just did our show. I decided to go with no guests. It was a real last minute thing, but I was really passionate about the episode because it was called Trust in the Process, which I have used so many times in my personal and professional life. And really the process in this case was talking about the mental preparedness, you know, the mental toughness, and then the resilience that you need to have. And that happens at all stages, whether it be on the game court or whether it be offside the court, right? And so we really were honing in on, I mean, I've been seeing so many people just TikToking and doing stupid shit before a game, before a tournament, before a tryout, where I'm like, why aren't you like in a corner somewhere with your headphones on, envisioning your what you're going to be doing on this court, you know? And then you know, moments in a game where I see kids lose kind of their mental state because they're listening to the crowd, they're listening to their parents, they're listening to everyone else around them. And then I talk about on the show a couple of players that recently were injured, some ACL injuries, some from, you know, a tibia injury, various injuries. And I'm like, you know, that's the resilience, right? To come back and to put the work in. And everybody knows I played elite basketball through high school, but did not get to go play in college because I got hurt. I had two career-ending injuries. And unfortunately, you know, I feel like we're not talking enough about that. You can train in a court, you can train with trainers, but you got to also train mentally. And so that's what this week's episode's about. So definitely check it out.
Love that. So make sure that you subscribe to her. Oh, whoa, hold on here. Whoa, the one and only Dan Lindsay in the house.
What is up, everyone?
Good to see you, my friend. Good to see you.
You as well.
You got to turn that camera sideways, dude. You're killing us with the vertical.
I look fatter with it sideways. Is that better?
See, we get a full view.
You look thicker, and I like it, sir.
You get a full up the nose shot. This is my best angle.
Oh, it's so good. Wait a minute, everybody. Hold the freaking phone.
It's here,
wait
baby.
A minute. This is my surprise.
This is your surprise.
Let's go. I don't even know if we have his walk-up music. What the heck? I think we cleaned it out.
Rocking the t-shirt too. Let's go, Greg. What's up?
Oh, man.
I actually had to ask Robert to forward the invite one.
Oh, my gosh. Greg Roberts. It is so
I'm
good
no
to
longer
have you
on
back.
The distribution list for the invite.
Well, you know, listen. Listen, we felt bad sending the invite to people and just like cluttering their inbox if they weren't able to make it. So we occasionally will kind of clean things up. We thought, you know what? You got stuff going on. It wasn't that you were invited, man. You were always welcome, dude. You're like an OG on this show. Man, what a surprise. Oh, man. I'm so excited that you're here. We got
to
send you some
back.
Do you want, okay, listen, do you want a glass, a mug, or a water bottle? We're just giving stuff away around here.
What the hell?
Can you do photos? Swags for logistics.
I mean, right there. Maybe you want
to the
you
YouTube channel? I guarantee Greg hasn't subscribed to shit. I got the water bottle already. I was saying glass or mug deal.
Look at the coaster.
All right, so Greg, which one do you want? We can take the graphic off. Which one do you want?
Mug would be great.
All right, we're sending you a mug. All right, it's on the way. We're we'll get you something.
Don't worry, they'll put the character of your face. You'll get a whole saying of everything. You get all that stuff. Get psyched.
It's gonna be amazing. That's for sure.
Buddy.
All right, hey. Speaking of swag, we got a little giveaway we got to do. So we did a little promotion this week for anybody that would subscribe to our channel and let us know about it. We put you into a drawing for a little giveaway. We're giving away some good stuff, and the winner gets to pick, and it's gonna be co-branded. So you get a little Word on the Street stuff as well as putting your logo on it as well. So we got the spinner of the people that did subscribe and let us know they subscribed. So we got that. We're going to put that up on the screen here and we're going to spin this thing and see who wins. All right. So Kyle, your name is in there. Your name is on there, my friend. So we'll see.
I want to see behind the scenes. Let me see the coding first because I want to make sure there's no screen line.
Yeah, we'll find out. All right. Let's go ahead and spin this baby up and let's see what happens here. All right. Who's going to be the winner? Who do we have? Ooh, and we got Mitch Kowalski jumping into the show at the same time. Oh, we didn't get to see who wins. We didn't get to see. Oh,
awesome. Yeah.
That is huge. Wasim and Nair's the winner. Oh my goodness! All right, we gotta get them.
Don't you have to be present?
Mitch, what's up, man?
How this works? Or...
What up? What's up, everyone?
Hey, Katie.
Good to see you, Mitch.
Yeah.
Good to see you as always, my friend. Climbing out of the dirty baby clothes and not getting much sleep these days.
You know, I'm doing the backup leg work, right?
You know, on this call right now. What are you talking about? What are we? Yeah.
He's gonna fight.
My sleep's okay. My sleep's fine.
You made the show. Things are going well. Do you have any new pictures this week? Surely your phone is just riddled with new pictures. You got a new picture?
I got tons of pictures. They need to come. They need to get sent out of this phone into a better spot, right? But I'll I got some updates. This kid's like 12 at this point, almost. Right?
Yeah. So, all right. Well, to close out what we just said, Wasim Manair, Manair Group, you're the winner of some co-branded swag. We'll be sure you get it. We get it your way. So thanks for playing. Thanks for subscribing. We appreciate that. We'll get something out. Get out to you. Get to pick what you want. So we'll take care of that. All right. It is time. Oh, Kyle, what?
So do I have to unsubscribe to YouTube now and then resubscribe to enter the next one?
I was going to ask that. I was a little hurt. My name wasn't on that spinner. I'm just saying.
Okay, so we'll get you in. Katie, we'll get you in next week. Kyle, don't unsubscribe.
Safe. We're going to unsubscribe from everything, and then that way we'll wait until the new contest goes down.
Maybe we'll put everybody in next week, excluding Wasim, since you know you didn't win. Maybe get another chance to win next week. Maybe we'll do that. I mean, we make the rules around here. We do what we want, so, you know.
Hey, we'll Trey. It is amateur hour.
always.
You got a second?
Yeah, Jeff.
Hey, listen, of course. I just want to plug what you said a couple weeks ago about getting your body scanned and taking care of yourself. We got a bunch of athletes here on board with us today. You know, yesterday I just had my aorta checked, and it was great because, you know, lifting, putting all that stress on your body for years and years, whether you're running, playing basketball, whatever, you should get it checked out. It doesn't take long to do that, and it's burden off your shoulder. You know, especially for Mr. Bain, he lifts a lot and he puts a lot of stress on his back and his chest and his aorta. Get it done, man. There's nothing better than having that burden off your shoulder when they say you're good to go, you know? Yep. So listen to Trey, man. Do it.
We've been doing the in-body
scan. Jeff, I appreciate that.
I just got a whoop. So we're keeping track of it now. Yeah, Bain.
Jeff, you've got a big heart, man, metaphorically. I've got a big one medically, so it's a condition, but I appreciate that, man. So thank you.
Also, Jeff, did you go to a doctor? Kyle would have examined you for free.
That's what I'm afraid of. That's exactly what I would be afraid of.
That's why you called me for a second opinion, Jeff. We talked about
second opinion. Yep.
Yeah, you're 3 C's and then 1 K.
My favorite moment from Jeff's speech is he talked about we're all athletes on here, and Kyle's like, yep. And I'm like, I don't know. I'm not sure about that.
Kyle. Okay, you can do a little fidget spinner, Trey. That's the only reason Katie, I think, got brought on, so Trey can show he can spin a ball on his finger. Yeah, look at that.
I got game, man. It's just the way it works.
That's a good one. But
to Katie's point and Jeff's point, a lot of us on here did play athletics, and I think that's a huge part of our success is what we learned in athletics, how we learned about discipline and perseverance and teamwork, communication, all those things. I went to a ninth grade basketball game this week, and you could hear a pin drop while they were playing because they weren't talking. And Katie, you know that. That's the death nail of a defense is to not communicate. Like, you should be hearing them all.
I can hear myself. Can we please communicate?
That's right. Exactly. But these are the kind of things you learn is to over communicate and to be clear and all those. I mean, there's just so many skills. So I'm so excited that you're doing what you're doing, Katie. It's good stuff. Let's jump into our first segment. Yeah, go ahead.
Check out KeachLegacy.org. You can learn, subscribe, all the things.
It's all good stuff, man. Keach Legacy Basketball. I love that. All right, let's jump into our first segment. What's the Watt? Sponsored by our good friends over at Ty Software. Love those guys. Creative bunch over there. Good people over there. So this segment's brought to you by Ty. Hey, listen, brokers, your business is a complex web of processes and technologies that must work together. And you need a partner who truly understands freight brokerage and your specific needs. The team at Ty Software constantly collaborates with the top freight brokers in the industry to build their revolutionary TMS. You want to scale your business? They'll help you get there. Schedule a demo today and see the difference by clicking on the link in the comments and or the show notes, or simply enter bit.ly/Ty-software in your web browser. All right. First story we got to talk about today. Katie, reason why I wanted you on the show. Did you guys see the NBA All-Star Weekend three-point competition and specifically the competition between Steph Curry, who some consider to be the greatest shooter of all time, and Sabrina Ionescu, who is phenomenal awesome. In her own right, probably the greatest shooter in the WNBA. And they went head to head on a 3-point shooting contest. That was some of the best drama I've seen. Like, I would watch that over the game and the dunking contest
all day.
It was good.
All day long. You know? And then she put on a show, man. Like, she put the pressure on. It was so good.
That was the best. That was probably the best takeaway from the entire weekend. I was in Indy Monday and Tuesday, which is the aftermath of the weekend. And one thing I got to say is Indianapolis went all out for this event, right? Every hotel door was custom wrapped. I mean, the every hotel, you know, I was just
that's Westin, what Indy does, man. That's what
man
Indy
the Westin does. The Westin downtown had an Indy car wrapped in the NBA All-Star game in the lobby. Like, they awesome. Really figured out how to tie this city in.
Midwest and, hospitality, baby.
Well, and if you flew in, they imported a basketball court, full size basketball court, into Indianapolis International. So yes, when you walk in, there's a basketball court.
Really? Oh, wow. Yeah. That's cool.
Legit.
And you went all out, but I think the game was overall a little bit disappointing, right? This is a very, very expensive ticket. They're expecting a great experience. And
disappointing?
I don't know. I think for the price of the ticket, I expected some basketball. These are guys standing around that didn't want to get injured overall, right?
I think I stopped watching after LeBron tried to give himself an alley-oop off the backboard and then did a fadeaway against nobody.
I turned it off then too.
Oh, but he's the greatest.
You know, 20 years ago you had Kobe and Jordan going at it in the All-Star game, and man, yep. Like,
I miss those days.
I miss those days when those guys just saw it as an opportunity to get after it. And now there's just so much concern and analytics and metrics and, you know, rest and health and don't want to get hurt. Man, those guys competed back then. I missed
that. I saw a statistic.
How about Bird and Magic? Come on.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
That's another great one, too.
So. I saw a statistic that the only Chicago Bull that attended was Benny the Bull, the mascot. No players, nobody else. Nobody front office, fully, nothing. Yeah. They sent the mascot as the roster.
So sad. So sad. We're going to sound like a bunch of old people, but that was the days back when you could really enjoy the game. And you know, the MVP actually meant something. I mean, those guys were shooting threes from 35, 40 feet. Like, I mean,
yeah, it was like a dozen half court shots in the middle.
I was going to say, there was a dozen half court shots.
Didn't Luka shoot one from three quarters?
It's just like, what are we doing? Yeah. You know?
I mean, if you think about it, the best part about going to a game is the half court, the halftime antics. So they're just making it, they're bringing all that to the game.
Yeah, I got
they're
bored.
Being smart with it.
I heard somebody talking about this. This is one of the downfalls of the game changing with Steph Curry making it more of a 3-point game. So now it's 3-pointers and dunks for the most part. And what they said was in the All-Star game, because everybody's shooting threes, the defense is more spread. So now the lanes are open. So it's either a 3-point shot or a dunk. And that's all it is now. It's fun when they're competing and they're actually playing hard in the regular season. I mean, the All-Star game just absolutely stunk. I was not a fan of that. But getting back to the 3-point shooting competition, I want to talk about this because I think we're in an age where, like, men's and women's sports is in spotlight right now. And I hope that we can all agree that there's a purpose for women's sports. We need to keep it separate because it's competitive in that nature. But how cool is it when they do come together for an event like this and give exposure? You know, how cool is it when you have there's a golf event now that's a team event where it's an LPGA player and a PGA player. And they're, you know, they're playing that event. You have mixed doubles and tennis, and those are great matches to see in that regard. Like, I love it when the sports are able to come together and expand that network. It's just phenomenal. You know, I'd love to see much more.
Definitely.
You know?
It's so cool because I don't know if watching didn't get to see it. Sabrina challenged Steph and came back and played at the men's line.
Yes.
No one has ever done that in history. And so, you know, yes, she played with a female ball, but she did it from the men's 3-point line.
Well, her hands are smaller. Like, it makes sense. There's a reason why they play with a smaller 100%. Ball, right? I mean, it makes sense.
Well, she's still sunk, what, 26?
27.
25, I think.
Yeah, it was crazy.
She hit 23.
That would be lying if he didn't say there was a part at the end on that last rack that he, like, is Adam's apple.
I got to make all these. Yeah. I mean, he had to make them all.
Question for those of you who played, though. I played at the park growing up, and that was about it. That court.
Yeah, you did.
Would that have messed with your shot, the, you know, green, you know, court where every time they make a shot, the star goes off under the basket or something like that? That That seems crazy. That's
semantics. It's an interesting comment, Greg. I actually had the same thought the other day, because if you've watched ball lately, the courts are all changing. And I'm not a fan of it. I think they look ugly. But most importantly, I'm with you. I think it's a distraction. And, you know, like when my girls go out and compete, we play on, you know, whatever court. This last weekend, we were in the Bronx. So you can imagine what we were playing on. And there's all these lines. And those are distractions because there's so many lines on those courts, right? So I'm with you. That was the part for me that was even more impressive, Greg, that both of them, but her particularly from the men's line, was able to still stay as succinct as she was in her shot with all the.
She made it look easy. That's cool.
I think street ball's where it's at. But me growing up, you have to have the broken glass and the needles on the ground to line up those shots, right? But when you don't have those in an indoor setting, it really throws my game off, right? So, there's four bullet rounds on the ground. That's traveling past those bullets.
Before he lost his hair, was actually an extra on the N1 mixtape tour. He almost made it to the main game.
Thank you. I appreciate you.
Yep. It's the flat floor that throws the game off.
Yes. That's awesome.
I like some street ball.
But the whole thing was absolutely phenomenal. And they just made it look so easy. Like, you just see when you have the greatest at what they're doing, they just make it look so easy. And it is so much fun to watch. I mean, every shot except those 3-point shots, the longer ones, every one of them looked like they were going in. It was just so much fun to watch. It was so amazing. I think it's incredible. Again, I hope they do more stuff like that, where you're starting to just kind of bring fan bases together a little bit and just showing off, especially what the ladies can do. The ladies just don't get as much attention in the WNBA. But man, those girls can play. They can play. And you think about this, like, think about Caitlin Clark. Like, let's just talk about her for a minute. I mean, she, you know, with Iowa basketball, she broke the record from the logo. I mean, get out of here. That was insane. I mean, Katie, would you ever take a shot like that in high school? Like, would you ever pull up from that spot?
No.
It was 2 minutes into the game. It wasn't like at the end. It was like at the beginning of the game, and she pulled up from the logo and nailed it.
And she said straight up, she's like, y'all knew I was taking that shot from the logo.
Yeah, y'all. She was absolutely planning, done. I mean, that's all about mental preparedness, right? She was confident. She had a plan. She executed on the plan. I got to see her in person. She played at Rutgers, so I took my daughter up, and it was an incredible experience. And seeing how she's changed the game for college girls basketball and selling out all of these stadiums, I'm just loving everything about what's happening around
her. I mean, something else great about her, too, though, is if you hear her backstory, she came up and she talks about how she wasn't shooting those long-distance threes. She was all about the basics, going from the blocks, going from the free throw line. And then all of a sudden, she started to get a little stronger and got a little more able to shoot the distance shot. And it's just unbelievable.
Yeah.
Hey, Katie, what do you think it takes? I mean, obviously, women's basketball has a fresh momentum, right? And there's a good thing on that. I love that. I'm a father of three daughters. I think the discipline of the game is really important, of just life lessons and the structure. So I'm very attracted to that, just as a structure program, to have something really important. But how do we make it more mainstream? How do we fill seats of WNBA games, in your opinion?
Good question.
So the biggest thing I think is to let the girls hoop, right? So one of the things that you know, I'm even watching at the high school level when I'm going to a couple games tonight. And the major thing that I see people go to is the fast-paced game. The biggest fear I also see on that same court is the coach who feels like they're out of control of the game. That's my style of coaching. I in fact, love fast-paced games. We press the entire game. We play man as much as we possibly can. I mean, that's what I think is going to bring in the crowds. If we there's too many people that have gone to it almost feels rehearsed because we're just practicing the play. And unfortunately, Mitch, I'm seeing too many kids just go to the spot and not understand.
Right, not playing.
Like you of
not
the
reading.
Game.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
I think all day long, it's let the kids hoop, trust that you taught them all the right things, and just let them ball and be there to encourage them. That's what I think my job is as a coach, is to encourage. And one note on the All-Star game that I think is the solution to the problem we just saw, let's let everybody who didn't get to play all season long go out on that court and play.
I like that. Because they're not worried about getting injured. They'll play hard. They'll play hard, right?
All season long, let's see what they're capable of, and let's take all those other guys off.
I heard a proposal of international versus American that could create some competitive, feelings possibly. But we'll see how it goes. But I think you're right. The fast paced nature of it is good. And we're going to highlight just real quick your future guest, JD Gravina, on your show, Katie, because at Western Illinois, I've watched him play and they're the same way. It's all about speed. He's like, time of possession doesn't matter in basketball. It's not like football. And so they take the first good look that they get. They're taking that shot, whether it's a three or a layup. They're pressing. They're playing fast. Go Leathernecks. That's right. Go Leathernecks.
Harvard of the Midwest.
And they fill out the gym. They pack out the gym at Western Hall because it's a fun game. To me, it's like the difference between softball and baseball. Like softball is such a fast game. It's really fun. And so it's attractive. If softball was the same speed as baseball, it wouldn't work. I think the same thing is true for women's basketball. It should be faster. Like they should just play faster. And it's much
better. Can I piggyback off that real quick?
Yeah.
So powerlifting mean even more niche than women's basketball. Same concept. Let ballers ball. Let lifters lift. The other thing that is crucial for that is outside investment. Those that are directly involved in women's basketball. So you think of companies that make, the balls, uniforms, they typically don't have a huge marketing budget. And so they're not going to put a ton of money except for the marquee events. So you need outside partners that are going to see the product, believe in it, and put their name on it. Shout out to Mitch and R2X. They actually took this to heart and are a title sponsor for the Showdown the Storm meet down in Daytona Beach Memorial Day weekend. It's huge to – thank you, Mitch. Seriously, like the amount of buzz it created that someone not directly affiliated with powerlifting would do that was huge. Because, again, there's not a lot of inside investment, so you need outside investment. Money equals exposure. If all of a sudden Kellogg's comes in and says, hey, WNBA, here's $10 million to put our logo all over, the courts, all of a sudden that gets a lot more exposure. And they have that money to then go out and do more advertising to get the ladies, better salaries, all that type of stuff. So it creates a flywheel the more and more outside investment you get. That's why if you go on the very, very far extreme, look at the NFL, people are clamoring every year. Amazon paid $125 million for one fucking game next year. For one game.
Yeah.
So
I'll take you one step further on that, because as a female, I've noticed that there are not enough brands. And I love Nike. I love Under Armour. So I'm going to say this and be a little bit of a hypocrite because I'm obviously sporting the apparel. But, they're meant for everyone. And I'd like to see – I met a CEO last week who she's making a shoe for women, by women, for the WNBA, for the girls playing on the court in middle school. Instead of going, hey, here's a Nike shoe made by a man for a man, and you go ahead and go wear that and figure it out. And that causes – believe it or not, plantar
injuries.
Yeah. Right. So I'd like to see being more supporters. And I mean, honestly, couldn't be more passionate about my own doing, because that's what it's about. If we're trying to align with corporations that wouldn't typically go, oh, well, so why do I want to support your mission? And it's like, yeah, because these are the executives of the future. These are the people you want in your company. And I love basketball. Basketball is just a vehicle. We want these kids to understand that after basketball, they want to go use the teamwork, the work ethic, the discipline, the attention to detail, all the things that they're learning.
That point guard is your future chief sales officer.
That's right.
That's right. And I'll say this as well. I also think that the WNBA needs to do a better job of helping their players create individual brands. I mean, look at Caitlin Clark. She is a brand. She's a brand. She's moving the needle. And she's a great...
Not consumed by Nike.
Right. And she's a great player, but the WNBA is full of great players, right? But who knows them? Like, you don't hear their names. You're not seeing them out there,
Who's
are
top
they in commercials?
Who's
right?
top
yeah, three? Who are the top three WNBA players? Most people can't. I can't answer that question. Most people can't answer that question.
Think about FIFA. Think about all the video games that we're really get in with the young generation. FIFA. The amount of people that are all into soccer now in the U.S. because they play FIFA. They have
teams. Nobody cares about soccer.
People care about soccer. I'll tell you, the young people I work with love soccer. They have their teams from European leagues that they follow because of the kit, because they played on FIFA.
Oh, the Europeans. So they care about football. They don't care about soccer. Got it.
Yeah, football. But I was doing an interview with PGA, and they brought me in, and they were asking, it was video stuff. And they're like, so what do you think? I was like, guys, you want to know how I started paying attention to PGA? It was playing Tiger Woods 98. I was like, that's how I learned who was hitting. That's how I liked golf, was because of these players.
Tiger Woods, y'all.
Yeah, you got to create that type of thing. And right now, it just doesn't exist in video games. Yeah. Like, why is that?
Most people I feel that way. That's how I learned about Super Mario Brothers. I mean, the same path, right? No, I'm kidding. But, Katie, one more question for you on that.
I learned about plumbing.
Who is the top three in your perspective of WNBA?
Oh, man. That's a hard question because – I'm not even going to answer. Sabrina stands out as number one. The other girls, I feel like it's just any given Sunday. I think we need more consistency. Sabrina's consistent. Like, she consistent, like Caitlin. I think the two of them are so consistent and stand out both at the NCAA level and the WNBA level. Everybody else, I think it's a fight. You know, there'd be 25 people I could put in two and three each. Like, they're not consistent enough. And so I feel like, and that all does go back to my comment about making sure that they're dialed in on playing ball versus just running plays and rehearses. I know that's what you wanted, but
no, I'm learning about it. Right. It's just a team in my backyard. And now after this conversation, I feel like take my kids.
Oh yeah. Right?
I'm at a point where
to Trey's point, if you're in Western Illinois, I've watched JD's games now. I'm talking to my girls about going out there and playing. Like, I think it is so cool, the style ball he's playing.
Yeah.
And a lot more people could serve to do it. I watched a high school coach the other night try in the second half, Trey. It was the third quarter, right? There's like 6 minutes left. She was running delay offense. I'm like, you can't run a delay offense for the rest of this quarter and all of next quarter.
We played a whole game that way in high school, and fans hated it. We played a whole game that way.
I would have loved
to have played that way when I was that age. All right, we just checked this out. We're just gonna end with this. Watch this clip. This is Sabrina.
There you go.
This is just. I mean, this is. She just made it look so easy. It was so good.
So confident. Look at the confidence. She's dialed in, man.
How did they get the court to look like that?
It was a glass LED court, which is also a problem. It's also a problem. Look at Steph Curry. He knows. He's like, dude, this is a problem. This is a problem. I love that.
That she would have won.
Yeah.
I didn't know it was a glass court.
Yeah. She only missed, I think, three shots the whole time. I mean, it was just like,
bam, bam, bam.
Like she's shooting layups, man. It's just so good. Neither of them hit those shots, you know, that different ball.
Nobody hit the starry one. Yeah.
Yeah. And then from here, I don't think she misses from here after this one.
I'm praying that they don't change all the court. Like, we can't have the courts look like this.
No.
I'm signing the petition.
I think that would be awful to do that during.
They're just pumping those babies out. Boom, boom.
Just like, clockwork. Man, it was just so amazing. It was so much fun to watch. I absolutely love that. It was so good. So good. All right, cool. Well, let's transition real quick, because speaking of personal brands, I had the chance today to talk to Michael Lombard. Do you guys know Michael Lombard? Lombard Trucking? You followed that guy?
Dude. Yeah, I think I sent him to you like 2 months ago. I was like, we need to get him on.
I know.
He's good, dude. So he's fired.
He's coming on
TikTok soon, is just my friend. So motivating,
yeah.
Too.
Yeah, he's coming on soon. In fact, he put this post out. I think we have it. Let me see if I can pull this up. He put this post out. It's hard to see, but this bus, if you look just on the right side there above the handicap sign, it's kind of a Hawaii, you know, like sign with the
hang ten.
Yeah, exactly. And that it's on the bus. So if a bus driver merges over and somebody gives them the way to do it, then he can push a button that puts that on the back of the truck. So I'm like, that'd be pretty dope to have on trucks, you know, when you're out on the road and have a little communication between the driver and us.
We have it though. The truck flashes his lights three
times.
Yes,
that's what we have. I love that.
Right. If you do it the right way and the truck respects the way you did it, he'll give you a nice little thank you.
I flash my lights and
you let them in.
Anytime.
Yeah.
Yeah. I wish that more truck drivers do that. But my dad was a truck driver locally, and I remember that was kind of a thing. You flash the lights, and that was kind of a nice way of saying it. But I thought that was pretty cool. But we are going to get Michael Lombard on the show soon. I think 2 weeks he's going to be on, something like that. And we're also working on getting him at the Broker Carry Summit. That guy is so passionate about drivers and taking care of drivers and carriers. Just such a cool brand. And you know, we want to help
him. History.
His family owned a trucking company for 60 years, from like 1923 to 1970, 80. I don't know. I can't remember exactly the span, but it was about 50 to 60 years that they owned a trucking company. And when deregulation happened, that's kind of what messed him up. But he's still really passionate about trucking. He drove a truck for a while. This guy trained for 5 marathons while driving a truck full time.
Wow.
Yeah, that's Greg, awesome. You got to love that.
That's awesome.
You got to love that dude. That guy said, hey, I got a 10-hour break, so I'm going to sleep for part of it, and I'm going to run, you know, 8 miles or whatever he decided to run. And he literally would park his truck, fly home, run his marathon, fly back, and keep driving. I mean, what a cool story. Just a neat story. So amazing. We're going to get him on here real soon. Looking forward to having Michael Lombard on here. Had a great conversation with him today. So good stuff there. All right. Let's talk about some transportation stuff out in the world. Do you guys realize that fuel card skimming is still a really massive problem? And there's some new players in the industry that are trying to make it easier for trucking companies to have security around that and not have that issue. But I didn't realize this was such a massive problem out there with fuel cards. But we're seeing some movement in companies working to fix that problem. But
you think technology could fix this? But what happens is these local drivers, they'll have an OTR guy pulling a load into the yard. A local guy will fill or top off the truck. Or I think it's very common on local fleets to get those going, right? And so there's a lot of fraud and theft into that. It's pretty typical. Anytime there's access to a lot of employees having, you know what I mean, to be able to dispatch those drivers, might sit in the seat for a week and quit, go to a different fleet. An active fuel card is still there under the name before it gets canceled, and there's one more fill up on that. So, I think technology, a fingerprint system, a PIN code, there's got to be some fix on this, right? So, yeah, it's not a common deal in my car. I guess it is, but it's not. I have confidence that it doesn't happen to me often, as long as I have a code or something to protect me.
Yeah, it's costing fleets up to $10,000 a month on average. Wow. In terms of just, yeah, so, and it's a pretty big issue that they're dealing with. So there's technology that's working on that, but yeah, they put in basically fake scanners, or they put them nearby so that they can grab the, you know, the information that way. And they install them at truck stops without the truck stops knowing about it, you know? And so it's just, you know, kind of an ongoing problem of finding information and then, you know, scamming them with that. So
it makes me wonder, Trey, like how much time is it taking them to install these things, right? Like,
doesn't take any time.
I think it's something that it's probably battery powered. It's something that they can just stick right on the side and it's close enough, you know?
I mean, they have it here in New Jersey at your regular gas stations where it's just a cap that goes over the.
I did see that.
Yeah. And as soon as you put that card in, it's got all your information on it. And even the guy that's running the pump doesn't even know it. They turn their back, they slip it on there, they got all your stuff. Yep.
It's becoming a problem. Another issue is the Port of Portland is running out of money and are potentially going to stop container service at the Port of Portland out in Oregon. They're asking the state to inject $10 million to keep the thing afloat, which is interesting because I think that, you know, they're facing the disruptions of container traffic going, you know, more East Coast or Texas and those areas, and they're, yeah, you know, they lose quite a bit of money. Plus, under the state of Oregon, tends to not be efficient in their how they handle their budget. So, pretty interesting to see about that. Port of Portland, that'd be something if the Port of Portland no longer could take containers. I mean, that's going to be a problem.
The West Coast is super competitive, right? Tacoma is the go-to besides Long Beach. But in the last 5 or 6 years, there's been these middle pocket ports, especially in like Central and Northern California, that have picked up very niche produce and some other things coming in from, you know, Asian imports. But anything on the West Coast is super valuable, super, super valuable. It's a big deal. The dredge is super expensive to get these massive, massive ships in. Tacoma is stealing that business, right? And so it's a very competitive deal. We want competition. We want diversity. We want different shipping options to be cost effective so there's not one market rate. Got to pay to play.
Yeah, I know. Hopefully they can turn around. I'll see what happens.
Don't forget about Prince Rupert, too.
Yep. Yeah, you got British Columbia is right there, too. Yeah, you got a lot of competition in a very short window stealing that business.
Yep.
Yep. So we'll see what happens with the port. Georgia. Georgia breaks the export record, almost $50 billion in trade. So again, talking about that, they've collected a lot of that. Savannah really, really picked up. That port's been doing really, really well. And so seeing some of the, just seeing the shifting, you know, movement of cargo, and it just continues. You got the Suez Canal issue, the Panama Canal with the water levels. It's just disrupting a lot of the, I think, the typical flows of freight. And it's becoming a little less predictable right now in terms of where things are going to end up.
Is anybody ever visited the Port of Savannah? Anybody ever done a tour?
Yeah. They did that for TMSA at Elevate. They did a port tour. I didn't get to go on that, but they did that. People said it was
the only port when you pull in, right? You go past the guard shack, you have an escort if you have a tour stop or do anything. And then you're driving, you see containers, concrete, and all of a sudden there's a cemetery right in smack dab in the middle of the port. That was there before the port, and they had to build around it. And so there's just a legacy. Oh, wow. Very, very old cemetery right in the middle. There's trucks moving around it, but don't touch that. Move around it, but it's pretty.
Yeah, unique. The Elevate conference last year was in Savannah, and it was on the river. And you saw these massive, cargo ships coming through during the show. It was fascinating to see. I mean, when you're on ground level on the sidewalk and this container ship, it's huge. It's unbelievable. Huge.
There's a bar in downtown Savannah called Tubby's. And Tubby's gives free shots to everybody as soon as if the container ship blows their horn when it goes past. If it does not blow the horn when it goes past, no one gets the shot.
Somebody's got to have
everybody out there.
Everybody's trying to blow the horn as he's going 5 miles an hour past. It's crazy. Yeah.
So we did. So let's shift gears for a minute to some social media news. We did show the video of Scott, some social media clips that we've put out. I feel like we need to play that one more time, Scott, just so people can see that.
I'm ready. Yeah.
Mr. Lover. I'm Mr. Lover. Mr. Lover. Sexy undercover. She call me Mr. Bombastic. Tell me fantastic. Touching on me box, she say it's a Mr. Roll. Mr. Lover.
Oh, that is so good. That's so good. Yeah, just put it on repeat. Just put it on repeat. Let's just keep watching.
Yeah, you need to put it on also. Send it to my wife. I can send it to her about an hour before I get to the house.
You warming
her up. There you go. That's right. Yeah. Listen, we're having a lot of fun over here.
Yeah. Well, I didn't see that coming at all.
Oh man, that's a classic. That's
a shout out to.
We show that one again. Can we do that one?
Yeah, we can roll that one.
Probably on it today.
I don't get it.
So good. Yeah, we're having a lot of fun over here. So shout out to Natalia and Morgan for having a little fun with our social media around here. But awesome. Scott, we'll get that to you, man. You can post it as well. But I thought that was just so classic. And man, kudos to you again for just following through. That was a lot of fun. I know it wasn't what you wanted to do, but man, it was so good. So good.
I wonder, Greg's probably just like, what is going on and why would that even
Trey has about 75 open bets that involve the Chiefs or the Royals at every given point. So
I guess I had my Niners head on, but then you probably assumed what exactly was going down there. So
I assumed it wasn't voluntary. I'll put it that way.
I mean, sure. These people keep making bets. I mean, you know, Nate Cross keeps betting when the Bills play the Chiefs and he loses every time.
It wasn't voluntary for Scott's daughter, who was forced to wake up and draw it on her father's chest.
She's great on it. You know, I wanted to showcase her skills.
Her artwork. Yeah, it was impressive.
Like, this is a work of art. This is a canvas. You got to get on it.
Yeah, she's just
this is going to get eyeballs on your skills.
It was so good. I mean, it was so
good. I'll say this.
It was close to trademark infringement. It was so good.
Man, I'm so pumped I got to hang out with Scott late last year and hang out with him in person, but I'm super pumped that Scott can follow through on a bet like that, right? His pride and his ego go secondary to his word, and that's an awesome dude right there.
Yeah, no shame in comedy. That was my big thing. No shame in comedy.
I'm going to have to make a trip to Idaho to hang out with him, though, because we can't get him on the road. We can't get him out to these events.
No, I'll be up. So next time, I'm going to hit up Greg when I get back to Chicago again. We'll have to link up, so.
Yeah, for sure. All good stuff. Hey, also, did you see the story about Charlotte the Stingray, who had a miracle pregnancy? This is pretty interesting. I don't know a whole lot about this, but the Georgia Aquarium, they have a stingray that apparently had a miraculous pregnancy. I thought that was pretty interesting. Do we have a clip about that? Do we have anything about that? I'm not sure if we do or not. Maybe we don't. I don't know. But I thought that was pretty. They thought that maybe sharks tried to mate with the stingray. No, we don't. And because she had a lot of ablations and things that go on, but miracle pregnancy. So we're going to see some stingrays being born in the Georgia aquarium coming up soon. So you're down there. Have fun with that. Didn't know that. Fun little story today. All right. We got to play a game here. But before we do that, a couple of quick announcements. Make sure if you haven't signed up yet for the Broker Carrier Summit that you do that. All right. It's Kansas City, April 22 through 24, brokercarriersummit.com. You're going to see a lot of the crew here, including, I think, our good friend Kyle might be producing the whole thing. So very excited about that. We'll see if we can get that contract signed soon. It's going to be awesome.
Yeah, I'm bringing the good looking filters for you, Jeff. You're going to look beautiful.
That's right. That's right. Making Jeff look real good.
Filters there, pal.
Kyle, can you make me have hair?
I'm going to take his mutton chops. I'm going to put the hair on you, Mitch.
Love that. Scott,
we're losing that shirt, baby. We're leaving you all.
Hey, this is all going to be gone. It will be.
You don't need a filter for me to lose the shirt.
Greg's back.
We need the handlebars. We need the handlebars back. That's what we need. We need the handlebars.
I gotta wait.
I'm doing the one with his helmet hair. And he's the clean shaven. That was the beautiful one with him and his wife that he posted on Valentine's Day.
It was impressive. When you sign up for the Broker Carrier Summit, make sure you use the coupon code BETA, BETA, and get 10% off. BrokerCarrierSummit.com. Sign up. It's going to be a great event. We're going to have a lot of fun.
Awesome.
Yeah, looking forward to it. All right, Jeff, it's time to play our game, man. So we're going to play today the hard game around here called Wavelength. We're going to see if we can all get on the same wavelength and get some points here. All right, so Katie, here's how the game works. If you haven't seen it before, our producer, Natalia, is going to put a category and a letter up on the screen, like food B. And then we all have to try to think of the same word. And the people that do think of the same word, if there's matches, they get points. All right, so let me go ahead and get my sheet ready here so we can start giving out points. Let's go ahead and put the first one on the board. It is, what do we got? Ooh, do we have one? There we go. J and movies. All right, so we got to think of movies that start with the letter J.
Jurassic Park.
No, you guys are ruining the whole game.
21 Jump Street.
We got to write it down. Do you guys forget this? You got to write it down.
I honestly don't even listen to the rules.
21 Jump Street.
Clearly you don't listen to the rules. All right. Thanks to my friends over at Aero Logistics today for their notepad. I'm going to be using that today. All right. So we're going to try to get a movie that starts with J. You already heard those guys clown a little bit with one, but we'll just throw it out there and see if we can get some matches here. All right.
I'm not trying to pen. Hold on.
Come on, Katie. Katie, I'll send you some beta pens. All right, you can get some beta pens. All right, don't show it yet.
No, it's my pen.
No, not you. I'm talking to Mitch. These guys.
I only have available mail to write my answers on today.
I love that.
Okay. Are we going to continue using J since all of us have already said something?
This will be our fun round here. We'll do it.
All right.
If you're following along online, make sure you put yours in the comments, and then you can enter as soon as we put ours in there. You can keep score as well. All right, here we go. Everybody ready? Katie, you got one? All right, here we go. On 3, 2, 1. I went Jurassic Park. Read that screen.
Just Friends.
Jackass, Just Friends, Jaws.
Jumanji.
Do we have no matches?
No, Jurassic Park, you and Scott.
Oh, nice. Scott, I can barely read that. All right, so Scott, you and I are on the board. Let's go. All right, so Scott and I get a point each. All right, here we go. Number two. You're muted. All right, here we go. E, a TV show with an E. Oh, okay, I got one. Yeah. Come on, Katie. Let's go. You and me.
Yep.
Oh.
Come on. All right. Everybody ready? Okay. 3, 2, 1. Everybody loves Raymond.
I got ER.
Oh. Yeah, I got
Yeah, emergency. Greg. Let's go. Emergency. All right. So, Greg, you and I get points. And then we got two ERs. So, Jeff and Katie get points as well. All right. Greg in the house. All right. Here we go. Okay. All right. Next up, next round. Ooh, F sports. Okay. This one should be easy. We should all get this one.
Like just the name of a sport?
Yep. Just the name of a sport that starts with F.
Oh, geez. Oh.
Here we go. All right, everybody. Football. That's what I got.
Football.
Football. Everybody gets a point. Mitch, what'd you have? You're writing now?
Oh, it was too late. I put freestyle skiing. Freestyle skiing.
Freestyle skiing. Oh, yeah,
that's not good. The passion is huge in freestyle skiing.
Listen, that's a type of skiing. That's not even, like, skiing is the sport. Freestyle is the kind. Like, it's not even.
Jeff, Jeff, show him your freestyle skiing tattoo and let's legitimize.
show him on your skin. It doesn't exist. It doesn't exist. All right. Jeff, next round. Here we go. Next round. A TV show that starts with H. Okay. Oh, we get background music too. Let's go.
Oh, H.
Oh, I got one. I got one. TV show that starts with H. TV show that starts with H.
No hamburger documentary.
Nobody's going to match mine.
No, yeah, I don't know.
I'm all right, 3, 2, 1. Here we go. Hawaii 5-0.
Oh.
Open face.
Howie.
Howie. I like Howie.
No points.
Howie Mandel.
No points. All right, no points. All right, moving on. Okay, next one. Next one. A celebrity whose name starts with I. First name starts with I.
Oh, you had to go first name? That's not cool.
First name starts with I. I know what you would do if it was last name. I know. What
I know. We could have been besties. Come on.
Who's ready? Who's ready?
I don't know any first name I.
Ice Spice.
All right. I got one. Nobody. Ooh, Ice Spice. That'd be a good one. I chose Idina Menzel.
Is it all done yet?
Yeah, that's good.
No, nothing on that. Okay, moving on. Next one.
You do know.
Okay, a movie
Love Actually
starts with an L.
Oh, I got this.
Maybe the Cable Guy's Big Adventure.
I got this. Trey, I'm counting on you. Think about me. Think about me.
Liar, liar.
Well, now you said it. Now it's in my head.
Yeah, it's, I don't know.
Oh, gosh.
Katie, the one Kyle says disqualified then?
I think I got you, Katie.
I'm the outsider of this thing, Jeff. I don't
can't
know.
Think
I'm
of it.
NWO at this
point. All right, what do we got? What do we got? What do we got? What do we got?
Love and basketball.
Love and basketball.
I put love with the, for the love of the game.
Oh, that's close, but no cigar. No cigar. All right. Okay. Next one. Next one. A celebrity whose name starts with a D. First name starts with a D. D.
The Rock. Dwayne Johnson.
The Rock. Yeah. Okay, I got one.
I got one too. I'm not proud of
Daniel me. Fish, Topanga.
You're not proud of this answer, Katie.
Not proud of this answer. I'm not gonna get it later on.
I think I know where you went. I think I know where you went with this. Donald All right,
oh,
here we go.
Donald Trump.
He rose the most disappointing former Chicago Bull ever.
Dave Chappelle.
Oh, it looks like someone saw the video link and now that's on Washington.
What'd you put, Katie?
Drake.
Oh, Drake. That was a good one. I put Dave Chappelle. Man. Okay.
A real celebrity.
All right. Next one. That would have been next one. Sports to start with a B. Ooh, there's several here. Badminton. Mitch is going to go with badminton, I can tell.
Wait till you see.
All right, Katie. No brainer. No brainer, Katie. No brainer.
Everyone knows Mitch loves breakdancing.
No brainer. All right. Here we go. Basketball.
Basketball.
Oh, I got it wrong. Bounce ball.
Bounce ball? What the?
Bounce ball is a form of basketball.
No it's chance. Athlete, no chance.
It's kind of like my skiing category. It's very niche, very, very go.
All right. Okay. All right. Hold on. Hold on. Basketball. Before you do this next one, here's the current score. Scott, you got 3. I have 3. Katie, you have 3. Greg, you have 3. Jeff, 2. Kyle, 1.
I should have
3. And then Mitch, nothing.
I
what?
One?
Jeff?
This is rigged. This is crazy.
Did you get basketball just now?
I got basketball.
Okay, sorry, Jeff. You got 3-2. All right, okay. A movie that starts with N. Here we go. Hopefully, we're getting towards the end here. A movie that starts with N.
Did Jeff get his pity point?
I got it. Yeah, we gave it to him.
All right, making sure.
A
movie with an N?
N.
Got this.
My gosh, I can't think of anything.
I can't think of anything.
Oh, my gosh.
How do you spell Night at the Roxbury? That's what I'm holding up.
Oh, that's nice. R-O-X-B-U-R-Y. All right. If you have something, put it up there. What do you got?
I got Never Say Die.
Neverland. Never Stay By.
Nightmare.
What is that? N-A-T-R-B?
That's it, baby.
Night at the Roxbury. Got it. Okay, we got no points. Okay, all right. Is this the last one? Final round. Here we go, people. This is a final round. Let's end on a high note here. Here we go. Country that starts with a Y. Ooh, ooh. Country that starts with a Y. All right, there's I got one.
I got one.
How many are there?
I was going to say, I like the one that...
How many are there? And what if I made a country? Does it count?
Ready? All right, here we go. Kyle. All right, we got Yemen.
Yugoslavia.
Oh, no, no. Is it Yesnia country?
Oh, so Greg, you put Yemen?
No, not a country. Damn it. Man.
Greg Yemen, Scott Yemen. Okay, so Greg, Scott, and I, we tied. Congratulations, fellas. Congratulations, fellas. Way to play. Way to play. All right, we're doing a really abbreviated version of This Week in Pictures. We got to wrap it up. Here we go. This Week in Pictures. Let's share it. Let's get them moving. Yep. All right, here we go. Robert Bain, don't know what that's all about. Moving on. Scott, what do you got?
Just before I came to band, we went and just played in the snow at a day. And then on the right hand side is my aunt who lives north of Bend, Oregon, which I went to go visit her.
Dude, love and those then, pictures,
man. Look at this. This is just me in action training some new people on the top left. This is a really cold lake. And if you scroll down to the left, if you zoom in, oh, you didn't get me in the picture. I'm cold plunging in the one on the bottom left.
Oh, nice. Right. Oh, we missed you. Oh,
you're killing me, Morgan.
All right. Actually, I think Natalia may have done that. All right, what's next? Moving on. All right, so some good stuff. We got some new swag. We got some new hats around here, people. Pretty excited about that. My daughter did a performance on stage at the youth event this week. Look at that picture right above my name. That's me senior year, or junior year prom, everybody. I'm on the left side with no hair. That's a little throwback picture. Got to see Mark Manera and Adam James and several others, yes. Brian from the Transportation Club of St. Louis. And I actually called Kyle this week, and this is the view I got on his phone. This is the lock screen for Kyle. When you call him, you get to see him out there on the golf course. I figured that was worth sharing. Good time. Yeah,
we
on
made
that.
Double par on that one, so that was the celebration we were doing.
Double par. Yes, and then, double par. Let's see what else we got. Anything else worth talking about? Let's see what else. Any other pictures? Nope, that's it. We're all done, everybody. Happy Friday. Enjoy your weekend. We will see you right back here next week for Word on the Street. And who knows? Maybe Michael Lombard will hop in. We never know. We'll see what happens next week. You guys have a good week. Thanks, Katie, for being on the show. Appreciate you, my friend.
Appreciate you guys.
See everybody. Bye. Take care. Bye.